Hi guys, welcome to another video. In this video, we will take a closer look at two values that are set in build.gradle file, compileSdkVersion and targetSdkVersion. We usually update both those values once the new Android version is released. But why is it so crucial to do it? And why there are two of them, since we usually set them to the same value anyway? Both compile and target SDK versions are crucial to handle forward compatibility in Android. So they are both connected with defining how to handle when the new Android version is released. Compile SDK version defines a version of Android SDK which will be used to compile your app. What does it exactly mean? Let me explain that using some example.
In Android 12, so in SDK version 31, there was a new API introduced that allows us to easily implement a splash screen that can be customized using those four properties. If you want to use that API in your app, you first have to download SDK version 31 in Android Studio and then update compile SDK version in your app to 31. Only then you can see those new properties, and only then you can use this new splash screen API in your code. That doesn't of course mean that you can use only this new API and forget about users who have older Android versions, where this API is simply not available. If the mean SDK in your app is lower than 31, you have to also provide an alternative way to display a splash screen for those older devices who do not have access to this new API.
Similarly, some methods or properties may be deprecated or even missing in new Android SDK. So, very often when you update compile SDK version, you will get new warnings and errors during compilation that you have to address. But changing the compile SDK version alone does not actually influence the behavior of your app in any way. It only gives you the access to the newer API. So how does Android system know if it can use new functionalities with your app or not? That's where the target SDK version comes into play. Target SDK version is a property that tells the system for which Android SDK version your app was designed and tested on. If the user runs your app on a device with Android version which is higher than the target SDK version that you define in your app, the system may introduce some backward compatibility behavior to make sure that your app still works and looks the way that you design it.
For example, in Android 12, the appearance of custom notifications was changed. Previously, you could use the whole notification area, but in Android 12, the system applies the standard template to all custom notifications, so they look more consistent. If your target SDK version is below 31, system will assume that you haven't tested that feature and would display notifications in the old way, to minimize the risk that notification will not be displayed properly. Only after you update the target SDK version to 31, the new notification appearance will be used.
It is worth noting that not all changes that are introduced in new Android version are targeted and use that backward compatibility mechanisms. In each Android version, changes are split into two groups. Behavioral changes for apps targeting specific Android version and changes for all apps, no matter which target SDK version they defined. The example of the latter may be the introduction of the one-time permissions in Android 11.
When the device uses Android version 11 or higher, and the app asks for a location permission, user can grant temporary access to that data, and app has to handle that case properly, no matter if it targets SDK version 30 or not.
So, as you can see, compile SDK version and target SDK version have completely different meanings and purposes. But it does not mean that those values are independent.
target SDK version cannot be higher than the compile SDK version, simply because we cannot target things we know nothing about during compilation. Ideally, the compile and target SDK versions should be equal and both point to the latest SDK. But of course only after you test that each change introduced in that version works smoothly in your app.
And that will be all in this video. Thank you all for watching. If you want to see more videos like this, hit the subscribe button and we see each other in the next video. Bye!